raise your hands and show everyone how many of you come down. Thank you. Yes. So welcome to Ipswich. So as we gather this afternoon, let us be grateful for this day and every day. Let us be grateful for each other, with whom together we share our lives in this community.
welcome you to this service of worship and thanksgiving for the ordination of Gail Doktor. Welcome everyone, people from New Hampshire, people from Ipswich, people from churches that Gail has served far away and near, old friends and family, soulmates, strangers. No matter where you are on life's journey, you are welcome here. God is good.
All the time.
All the time.
God is good.
Amen. Amen. Would Tara also come?
Friends, we have an opportunity now to share together the words that you'll find in your bulletin in the prayer of confession. Confession is a time that we take to recognize that we are out of right relationship with God, with self, and with neighbor. And so let us use these words that are written here for us to be in a time of prayer. In this season of Advent, you call us to be the lights in the world. We are asked to prepare the way for the coming of Emmanuel. Yet we confess we are ready, and we wonder if we ever will be. We struggle to find and feed the flame within. Humbled, we give ourselves into your dream. May you walk as children of the light, shaped by the Creator, and baptized.
Oh. Behold, he that keepeth Israel shall neither slumber nor sleep. The Lord is thy keeper. The Lord is thy shade upon thy right hand. The sun shall not smite thee by day, nor the moon by night. The Lord shall preserve thee from all evil, and he shall preserve thy soul. The Lord shall preserve thy going out and thy coming in, from this time forth and even forevermore.
Will you pray with me, please? O Lord, may the words of my mouth and the meditations of each of our hearts be acceptable unto you, our rock and our redeemer. In the name of the Creator, and the Christ, and the Holy Spirit, we pray. Amen. I have a meditation for you this afternoon about the call of God. And I want to start with a very quick story about how I first met you, Gail. You might not remember this, but you were giving tours at the local elementary school when I first moved to town. And on the second floor was a set of beautiful artwork that was made by the children of the elementary school. It was made one set of felted art and another set of sculptures that had a fountain. And your two children, Sarah and Jesse, were too little to have made either of those pieces of art in those days. But you knew all about them. You loved the piece of felt and explained it to us, how it had been made and tumbled. And then you explained to us the fountain, how it had been shaped by the children and how the river had once run through it, but it wasn't on that year because they were fixing it. And you explained the art of it and the technology of it and the plumbing of it, and you knew everything about it. And I thought to myself, this is a Renaissance woman. She knows everything about this art that her children are too little to have made. And she is so capable. You are so inspired, teaching us that we should come and bring our children to the Winthrop School and love being in this town, back when we were first discerning where to go. Thank you for that tour and for helping me that day and so many of us here to know where to go. In the psalm that we read today, we hear about the question of the pilgrim who's walking in the mountains, wondering where to go and where his help will come from and how he or she will get by in this mixed up, crazy, dangerous world. And then we hear the priest answering that pilgrim saying, your help will come from God, who will make sure your foot will not be moved, who will make sure that you will be safe in whatever beautiful and sacred way that will come together. You will always be watched and guarded and kept and loved, and that Holy One watching you will never slumber or sleep. And so as I think about the beauty of that psalm, calling us to think about our dangerous places, of the rocky roads we've climbed, the hills, the mountains, the battlefields, the hospital wings. I love the images that the psalmist gives us in this Psalm of Ascents, which is part of a series of Psalms of Ascent, saying it's okay to ask the questions, and it's okay to welcome the answers. It's okay to be a teacher and a learner. It's okay to walk with God full of fear, and it's okay to give your fears to God. And my sense for you, Gail, this day at your ordination is to be those two voices in that psalm, to be the pilgrim and also the priest, to ask the question, to bring the fear, to bring the climb, to bring the hope, and at the same time, to bring the comfort, the reassurance, the blessed confidence in God that the priest offers to the pilgrim. Now, your journeying with our church has taken you on many mountains, and it's very delightful to remember some of them. I remember one blinding rainstorm mountain when we were on a bicycle trip in the Berkshires, and you were the sag wagon driver, and the youth group was there, and we thought we would get up a mountain easily that morning and have our picnic at the top, but the rain came so suddenly and surprisingly that we all had to evacuate that plan. And you were great at helping us pray about it and helping us change course and keeping us safe, helping us be assured yet again. And when we shared the sacrament that night, your faith, as you thought about the day, shone so brightly, so clearly. And I've been rereading our journals from that trip, finding your funny words about the avocados that got chopped and the rain that got wiped out of people's eyes and how many trips it took to ferry the bikes back to the church where we were sleeping and what that was like for you. Always glad and joyful and resourceful. Already quite a bit of the priest as well as the pilgrim. At Harvard Divinity School this week, there's been a series of talks about being allies with the children of Syria who are in refugee camps. And one particular speaker, Alexandra Chen, who's been there teaching this week, who is a student in the graduate school and an expert in child trauma, spoke about her work at the edge of Syria in a refugee camp. And as I think about the call to be both pilgrim and priest, I think she's a perfect example. She's a therapist, a childhood trauma therapist, and she speaks 10 languages. And so she speaks this kind of Syrian Arabic that's right there in the camps and can understand the people perfectly as she faces them. And they've been through a lot. The children have been quite beat up. And they love her. And the way she puts it when she speaks, she says, I'm the only Chinese person there, so they look for me, they know when I'm coming because I stand out. And they come and tell her their stories again. And she brings a kind of healing balm to them that's a combination of understanding and kindness and trust and faith and belief in them, even though they're quite beat up. So when I think about your challenge and this opportunity that the psalmist gives us to be the pilgrim and the priest, to be the questioner and the answerer, to be the seeker in the rain and also the reassurer of all the goodness of God, I love to think of Alexandra Chen as one teacher of that model because she's right in the thick of it. She doesn't have everything all set. She's tiny and fragile and vulnerable, but she's so powerful there at the edge with the common language and the compassion and the love and the courage. I think that's exactly what the psalmist promises us will get us through, that things will be tough and we'll be afraid, and the mountains will be tall, and there will be rain, and we might not understand all the next steps, but God's hope will carry us step by step through it, and we'll be okay. So I thought in conclusion I would just sing a little bit of the song from the Cherokees that says, Aho, the Creator and the creation are one. As we think about that other river today, where the people are beginning to assemble in huge numbers at Standing Rock. So from the river at the Winthrop School to the river of rain running down your ears on the church bicycle trip, to the rivers and storms of the Psalm that the priest promises us will be okay in the middle of, to one more river that our country is longing to keep clean. I sing you this song. One day, Yahoo, one day, Yahoo, Wendy-ya, whoa-ho-ho-ho, hey-ho, hey-ho, ya-ya-ya, ya-ya-ya.
Judge people and nations by your righteous will, declared in the prophets and the Good afternoon.
Here at First Church, the tradition is for prayers of the people to really come from the people. And this afternoon, I invite your prayers, and then in response, I will say, God, in your mercy, and the congregation will respond, hear our prayers. And please hold your prayers for Gail, because we could be here until next year. We all have so many lovely prayers for Gail, and we'll have a special time with those. Where are you, Gail? Oh, back on the other end of the world. But of course, we hold you in our hearts and prayers this day. Are there prayers for the people this afternoon? Yes.
For my daughter,
for your daughter Allie, who's on her way to Standing Rock. God, in your mercy.
For my cousin Terry, who struggles with cancer.
For Terry, who is struggling with cancer. God, in your mercy. Struggling with a disease that's unfortunately not curable at the moment. God, in your mercy. Come on, people. I know most of you, and I know you have more prayers in your hearts, and trust that God hears those prayers, both spoken and held tight within our souls. God, in your mercy. Absolutely. For all the people who are dealing with the devastating fires throughout the country, Oakland and Cambridge and the Smoky Mountains, God, in your mercy. Thank you. For those who are experiencing homelessness and sleeping outside and wandering the streets, God, in your mercy. Justice and healing in our nation and for our work in it. God, in your mercy.
For all those that find the holidays to be such a difficult time.
For all those during this holiday season which experience a difficult time. God, in your mercy.
For those that give of themselves above themselves.
For those who give of themselves and of themselves. God, in your mercy. From those suffering from addiction, God, in your mercy.
Hear our prayers.
God certainly hears our prayers and cares deeply about each one of us. Thank you all.
This is the community of communities that has nurtured Gail Pomeroy Doktor and led her to this moment of ordination. People of God, look about and beyond these walls. Imagine those we are called to serve. The ones God so wishes us to reach, the ones who are waiting to be refreshed by good news. People of God, Blessings be unto you at this time of dedication and commitment. The Northeast Association of the Massachusetts Conference of the United Church of Christ greets you in the name of Jesus Christ, the head of the church.
First Church in Ipswich, United Church of Christ, after carefully considering the call to ordained ministry of Gail Pomeroy Doktor, respectfully requests that the Northeast Association ordain Gail to the ministry of the Church of Jesus Christ, consistent with Scripture and with the traditions of the Church Universal, and according to the faith and order of the United Church of Christ.
The Northeast Association has reviewed the request of the First Church of Ipswich, United Church of Christ. We have prayerfully examined Gail Pomeroy Doktor, considering her fitness for ministry in Christ Church. We are pleased and honored on behalf of the United Church of Christ to ordain her into the Christian ministry. That's right, Gail Pomeroy Doktor, servant of God, we invite you to come forward as a sign of your consent to be ordained into Christian ministry. She's dancing up the aisle. Shall I send? Who will go for us? Then I said, here I am. Send me.
Gail, there are many promises you will make in ministry. Every day there are and will be many opportunities to say, I do and I will, and help me God. And all those future ascents and the ascents you make right now are the basis, the foundation for your ministry. So I encourage you, when there's need for reflection, when the road is hard, when there's reason to celebrate, remember the call and remember the promises you made today, and may they sustain your ministry. So Gail, before God in this congregation, we ask you, are you persuaded that God has called you to be an ordained minister of the Church of Jesus Christ? And are you ready, with the help of God, to enter this ministry and to serve faithfully in it?
I am, with the help of God.
Do you, with the church throughout the world, hear the word of God in the scriptures of the Hebrew Bible and Christian Testament? And do you accept the word of God as the rule of faith and practice?
I do.
Do you promise to be diligent in your private prayers and in reading the scriptures as well as the public duties of your office?
I do, God.
Will you be zealous in maintaining both the truth of the gospel and the peace of the church, speaking the truth in love?
I will.
Will you be faithful in preaching and teaching the gospel, in administering the sacraments and rites of the church, and in exercising pastoral care and leadership?
I will, with the help of God.
Will you honor all confidences shared with you?
I will, with the help of God.
Will you seek to regard all people with equal love and concern, and undertake to minister impartially to the needs of all? And finally, do you accept the faith and order of the United Church of Christ? And will you, as an ordained minister of this communion, ecumenically reach out toward all who are in Christ and show Christian love to people of other faiths and people of no faith?
I will, with the help of God.
People of God, you have heard the promises Gail Pomeroy Doktor has made. What is your will?
By the grace of God, she is worthy.
She has been faithful to her call. You have brought her to this day, and we ask you to be with her as she continues her journey in the ordained ministry. We ask this all in your name. Gail, may your deep ocean spirit, your waves of boundless creative energy that infuse all you do, continue to bless your ministry and all you encounter. May your embrace of all the tides of life, the low tides, the ebb tides, and the moon tides, continue to sustain and guide you as you offer your big storm tide of God's love to the world. Dearest Gail, it is not possible to send you forth without into a future. It is not possible to send you forth into a future without recognizing your ministry of the past. For your vibrant and creative soul heals and transforms from the depths. And it got me through my hardest class in divinity school, Spanish. May your ministry in Jackson mountains. May the steep terrain build you up and the views from the top be spectacular and fill you with unspeakable joy. May you find moments of sacred pause that pick a notch. May there always be hope in the stark yet sacred landscapes, for nothing can separate you or those you serve from the love of God.
Dearest Gail, I remember hearing your spiritual biography, autobiography, IMS, Intro to Ministry Studies at HTS, and I am grateful that God has given you the capacity to embrace your call to serve others and to help them find their way through their deepest and darkest times. In a world full of grief and pain, you give us hope. You embody God's hope and light, and we need you. I give you thanks, and I give God praise for who you are.
Okay, well, now that you are charged, we're going to engage in the ancient ritual of supercharging, otherwise known as the laying on of hands.
We wanted to invite you. Exactly.
I'm going to move her into the middle.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Because we're going to set you among the way in the middle. So we're going to set you among this people. That's right. Rub your hands together. Get them ready. And let Gail's family to come close first. Superchargers are going to engage in a symbolic act whereby the church in every age recognizes God's call to ministry in the lives of faithful men and women and asks the Holy Spirit to confer on them gifts for ministry.
Spirit of the living God, pour out your grace on this your servant Gail this day. May the energy of the many hands here and the energy of the many saints who've gone before fill her with fire and memory and courage and hope. We think especially of those who have died. We call them into our spirit and our presence. And we think of those who are yet to come. And we call forth for their energy as well. And we think of Jesus, who laid hands on his apostles so long ago, and whose hands were then laid on another round of beautiful servants, and whose hands were laid on women and men who worked and dreamed and loved and healed and fought for justice, spoke up and suffered. We think of every one of them, of all of your servants, your prophets, your martyrs, all of your healers, your workers. And we too place our hands, remembering their hands, on this your servant, Gail. Fill Gail with your grace which knows no end, and make of her a servant and a server, a priest and a pastor. Make of her a woman of fire and faith and clarity and justice and joy. In the name of the Creator, and of the Christ, and of the Holy Spirit, we pray. Amen.
Yeah, we do. Stay close, everybody. Then you can rise up and look around. Because it is in the midst of the people who have helped lead you to this time and place, and in the midst of the people you are called to serve, and most importantly, in the name of Jesus Christ, the head of the church, and by the authority of the Northeast Association of the Massachusetts Conference of the United Church of Christ, that I declare that you are ordained into the Christian Church, our Church of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Praise God. Amen.
Love
And there are mornings I wake up going to work and I'm like, oh my God, I do not want to wake up with a butt today. I do not want to go hear about more people's like life problems. I have enough of my own. Fashion critique is a real thing. But what gives me the strength to wake up every day and rather than see my job as a burden, but rather a privilege, is my mom. Because I hope to be half the woman she is, because she's the only person on this planet I know that has been through what she's been through and decides to go out every day believing in love and hope and faith. And yeah, that's why she is going to change so many lives, because of you, I want to wake up every day and try my hardest to be a good person, even when it's not easy, because it's not easy. And no one wakes up being like, oh, I can't wait to be a good person today. No, it's hard. But the woman who showed me that all the hard days of trying to be a good person and that it's worth it in the end is my mom. And I know that if she can do that for me, she's going to do that for every single person that she touches.
From Jean Parker, who is a member of the church and a nursing home in Maine. And Mary Lou and Betty went to gather the blessing yesterday in the drums. And one more presentation. With many blessings, we will sing to you our last hymn.
Wait.
Oh, one blessing.
So, Gail, this is the promise of the Bible from the Massachusetts Bible Society, which is gifting you with this on the event of your ordination, because you are now appointed a teacher of its truths. And this. This is your ordination certificate. Take it and frame it and put it in a prominent place, and remember that Jesus calls us to be leaders who serve.
have our final song to sing to you. Go tell the mountain, which is exactly what we want you to do.
What a wonderful world.